My setup involves two 150 watt solar panels, a 12 volt 100 amp battery, a charge controller, and an inverter with some cables. I'm going to show you in this video how I wired everything up, what came with my original setup, and then 50 watt solar panels. I then bought a red and black extension cables that come with the MC4 connectors on the end. This is 6mm squared cable, which works out to be around 10 gauge. These cables are a bit thicker. I stripped these 4 gauge wires at one end, ready to connect to the charge controller. All we need then is to mount our inverter and plug the wires onto the battery. Here you'll see I used two branch adapters, allowing me to connect these solar panels in parallel, which is where you grab both positive cables from your solar panels and plug into the branch adapter, and plug your two negative wires together and plug them into the branch connector. So our two positives are together and our two negatives are together. I've screwed on the positive and negative cables that come from our charge controller to our battery. Now we're connected to a battery, we'll have a display on the charge controller. This will show us the solar panel on the left hand side, battery in the middle, and I haven't, but if you wanted to, you could add some 12 volt lighting on the right hand side, or 12 volt socket, which you could cable directly onto the PWT charge controller. But we'll be looking to add on an inverter connected to our battery, so we can use normal 3-pin plug sockets as well as USB ports. Cables that come with the inverter have these crocodile clips that come with it for a more permanent basis. I didn't want to keep these crocodile clips on the battery, but I'm just plugging them on now just to test it out and make sure it works. But then I'll look to connect some thicker wires onto the battery and add some breakers in as a permanent fix. For now, I use the wires that come with it, and I can see the inverter is working. Solar panels also received this little booklet, which had some good information in, which I thought I'd share with you, so you can pause and have a little read if you'd like to. Then we're going to look at adding on some thicker cables going from the inverter to the battery. But first, I disconnect the cables from the solar panels. As it's daytime, the solar panels will be sending down voltage, so by unplugging them, it will then be safe to work on. So take as many safety measures as you can. Here I show you the positive and negative wire, which will connect to the branch adapters, which connects the two positive wires together and the two negative wires together. Now I've unplugged the two solar panels, I disconnect the positive wire and I measure it up to add a 30 amp breaker. So if there's any short circuit, or if the wire overheats, if the amperage gets to 30 amps, this will then trip the breaker, breaking the circuit and stop the wire burning or creating a fire. So my whole idea in adding in all these breakers to the positive wires is just to make this setup a safer setup, and for whatever reason any of these wires might overheat, the breakers will go off as we look to prevent any fires. There's many different styles of breakers with different maximum amperage, but for these 10 gauge wires with the MC4 connectors on the end, these cables have like an external coating around them, and when stripping them I notice it's like stripping two sets of PVC coating. There's many different setups, and do plenty of research before creating your own setup. The length of the cables and the copper core size of each cable can affect the voltage and the amperage. Seek further advice when doing this for yourself. Now I'll screw this back into the positive side of the PWM charge controller. Then I'm going to look to screw the 30 amp breaker to the board. Look to add another 30 amp breaker onto the positive cable going from the battery to the charge controller. But first I disconnect the cable from the battery so that the circuit is broken, so that I can work on cutting down the positive cable. First I tidy up the negative cable, running it around the back of the board, allowing me space to connect the 30 amp breaker for the positive wire at the front of the board. I place the breaker on the board and size up where I want it. Then I cut and strip the ends of the cable so that I can connect both ends to the breaker. Okay. Now simply push in the switch on the breaker, which creates the circuit. Now you see power from the battery to the charge controller. Then I'm going to connect my positive and negative cables back into my solar panels and show you how I hang these solar panels on the wall by two bolts either side. By using the branch adapter, this allows these cables to stay in a parallel setup, which will keep this at 12 volt. When connecting these in series, the voltage will then be added together. So in parallel you add up the amps, and in series you add up the voltage. If you're looking to learn more on parallel and series, there's many good videos out there explaining the difference of the two, depending on what charge controller you have, how many panels you have, how many batteries you have, and what cable you're using. And I may upgrade to a MPPT charge controller, which was priced around £100 when I looked. Here you see, as I switch the lever on the breaker, we then have the image of the solar panel. But first I remove the crocodile clip cables that come with the inverter. The thread size on the inverter is a 6mm thread, which when ordering I was able to decide whether I had 8mm, 6mm, or 6mm one end and 8mm the other. The thread size on the breaker was also 6mm, so I was able to select a 6mm lug at the end of the cable when ordering. Now I'll switch all of the breakers, creating a circuit for the solar panels, the battery and the inverter, and then turning on the inverter switch on the right hand side. Now the setup's all on and good to go. I just want to add on these battery terminal covers to stop anything metal falling on top of these terminals and causing any issues. As there's two wires connected to the battery, I need to cut these to make them bigger. So here I've looked to cut them up to allow me to then cable tie two of the flaps to the two cables, securing them into place, whichever way works best for you on keeping these in position. Then I've used plastic cable ties to go round the covers, connecting to the cables to try and seal them in position. I like the fact that now I have outside lights that will come on, which are completely powered by the solar panels, and when sitting or working outside I can plug in my laptop or charge any 12 volt devices. Thanks for watching, subscribe for more, I'll leave links and information in the description below. Welcome to the channel and I'll see you in the next one.